I went to the woods. I went to the woods.
I went to the woods.
I went to the woods.
I went to the woods.
I wanted to live deep and suck out all
the marrow of life.
I went to the woods because I wished to live deliberately,
to front only the essential facts of life,
and see if I could not learn what it had
not
to teach.
When I came to die, discover that I had not lived,
that I had not lived.
I went to the woods.
I went to the woods.
I wanted to live deep and suck out all the marrow.
To cut a broad swath and shave close.
To drive life into a corner
and reduce it to its lowest terms.
I went to the
woods. I went to the woods.
I went to the woods because I wished to live deliberately.
My spirit at once gave the preference to this recess among the pines, as if it had found its proper nursery.
How long we may have gazed on a particular scenery and think that we have seen and known it, when at length some bird or quadruped comes and takes possession of it before our eyes and imparts to it a wholly new character. The heron uses these shallows as I cannot. I give them up to him. I cannot come nearer to God and heaven than I live to Walden even. I am its stony shore, and the breeze that passes o'er. I left the woods for as good a reason as I went there. Perhaps it seemed to me that I had several more lives to live, and could not spare any more time for that one. It is remarkable how easily and insensibly we fall into a particular route and make a beaten track for ourselves. I had not lived there a week before my feet were a path from my door to the pondside, and though it is 5 or 6 years since I trod it, it is still quite distinct. The surface of the earth is soft and impressible by the feet of men, and so with the paths which the mind travels. How worn and dusty, then, must be the highways of the world, how deep the ruts of tradition and conformity. I learned this, at least, by my experiment, that if one advances confidently in the direction of his dreams and endeavors to live the life which he has imagined, he will meet with a success unexpected in common hours. He will put some things behind, will pass an invisible boundary, and he will live with the license of a higher order of beings. In proportion as he simplifies his life, the laws of the universe will appear less complex, and solitude will not be solitude, nor poverty poverty, nor weakness weakness. If you have built castles in the air, your work need not be lost. That is where they should be. Now, put the foundations under them.